guys. So today's episode will be all about HubSpot. So if you are using HubSpot as your CRM and you don't like the default menu, mobile menu design in HubSpot, then I created a customized mobile menu designs. So if you want that to be integrated into your HubSpot website, then make sure you follow along in this video because it doesn't involve any technical skills. I will provide all the CSS code and the JavaScript code and step-by-step tutorial as well on how you can integrate or how you can customize your menu on HubSpot. Okay, so without further ado, let's begin. Hi guys, so let me just show with you the default mobile version for the HubSpot. So this is the default menu in HubSpot, and we will I'll give you like the code on how you can come up with this kind of responsiveness in mobile version. So I already tweaked the CSS on this, and I think I also tweaked the default jQuery. But yeah, let me just check. And also I have like I just created a simple mockup for this menu because I'm gonna actually revamp some of the stuff in here to make it more responsive and more cleaner. So actually this is the design for this website, for this blog rather. So this is the mobile version that I would like to come up. Okay, so this one, and then the mobile should be something like this. Let me just remove that one. So something like this, like there is a menu in here, and then the two buttons, and then the call icon, and then there will be a CTA. I'm not sure yet what will be the CTA that we will put in here, but basically that will be the full the design for this. But our goal right now, the things that I'm going to show with you now is how to implement this kind of vibe. Okay, so first let me just log into the HubSpot account, and then login.
By the way, if you find my video helpful, feel free to subscribe to my channel. Click that subscribe button and that like, thumbs up, and the bell notification if you want to receive new videos from me.
Sorry. So you should able to see this part. If it is already logged in, then go to the edit listing template. By the way, I would expect that you have familiarity with the designer tools in HubSpot, otherwise it would be a bit hard for you to follow on this. So I have a module called header module, and if you just want to get the code and access the code, then you can go to my link description below, because I will provide the download link. It is linked to the HubSpot marketplace. I'm gonna provide the link if you are interested on just installing the menu on your HubSpot portal. But anyway, so I did this kind. So I have five fields in here. I have fields for a simple menu, okay, because there is a menu in here that is visible, and I have a menu for the let me just open this one. If this is the menu that I'm trying to say. Okay, so I have a menu for the simple, okay, and then I have, actually let's delete that one, this is not necessary, and I have a mobile menu. So I have two types of menu. The mobile menu for this sub is hidden, okay, and then in this part here there is a custom menu. This is for the mobile menu, and then this is our logo, and this is for the title, this one, and the logo will be this one, and then the divider, this part, and then we have a main menu. So this main menu will be only visible on the desktop version. So as you can see here, at media, min width, if it is 10, 23 px wide, then the primary menu, which is this one, the mobile, is displayed none. Okay, now first thing is you need to check your HubSpot. Make sure that this is the jQuery code for that. So we have this code in here. I believe this is the default jQuery for the HubSpot. And did I change something in here? Okay, I did not change something. So just grab this code. By the way, I'm gonna put it on my article version for more information, because sometimes I miss some information in my video. So I put it on the blog version for further, you know. So let's go back with the heading module, and then go to the main style. So if you are using HubSpot, if you are using the default menu, because the CSS there and the jQuery are all similar. So if we are using similar code, if you use the default from HubSpot. So this is actually the design, like the animation thing in Hubs in the default mobile version. Now if you just need to add this code that I've written here. So it's called for custom mobile. So I have this code. So I added the CSS code for the mobile hyphen open CSS class. This one actually triggers every time you click the hamburger icon. So this one, you just need to copy this until this part. So if you copy this one, and again, I'm gonna put it on my link description. I'm gonna put it on my article version. And then also provide the animation here. So this animation will actually look, this is something like that. So that's why it is a bit animating, because I have this scale bottom animation. So you just need to copy this one. And again, I will provide the link description. And then these are the default, I believe these are the default boilerplate on your custom menu in HubSpot. So yeah, I did not change anything in here, I believe. So I did not change anything. But if I did, if I change some selectors in this custom menu in HubSpot, again, I will put it on the link on my blog version for further further details. So after you put that code, and then make sure you save this, okay, put it on the code, put it on the CS on your CSS files, okay, and make sure that your header is linked, the CSS is linked to your module, okay, and the jQuery as well. And then if you refresh this one, you should able to have this kind of vibe, okay? Like it occupy, because what I actually did in here is I make, so let me just explain with you a bit what I did in here for the master hyphen style. So basically I make the mobile style like transparent black. So this is the what it means in here, okay. And then I set the Z index to 999 to make sure that it covers all of the other elements in this page. So if you can see here, the header, the body section, the footer is covered with a block opacity, something like that. And I make sure like the position is in fixed, and then the width is 100% and the height is 100 viewport. So it cover entirely on the page if it is a mobile version. And then I added some information here as well, like the main width, which is this one. So I don't want to just cover everything. Like I want to have this kind of vibe in here, like it's only 80%. So this is actually the code means like main header, which is the horizontal UL, and menu depth one is 80%. So that's why there is a slit in here, like 80%. So that's what it means. So basically this is just the code that you need to get. And then all of these are already the default files from have spot default or the boilerplate. So if you're using the boilerplate, then you are good to go. But if you're not, then probably you need to change some of the CSS files, some that, yeah. So just copy all of the stuff there to get this kind of vibe. I hope you find these things valuable, and make sure you subscribe and click that bell notification so I know that you love seeing this kind of videos. It's also very helpful if you leave a comment on this video description. That will encourage me to create a lot of videos related into this topic. So I can weigh in what topic that I'm going to prioritize to publish or schedule. Otherwise, if I didn't see any interaction or any engagement in this video, then that's the signal that I need to switch on other topics. So your comment, your liked is super, super important, so I can create a lot of videos related into this topic, and you subscribe as well. That's it for today, guys, and have a great day.